Alright, and here we are. We're back again. Now, where were we? We were looking for Edgar because we had just gotten Sarah. So let's just continue down this this long dusty trail. So now we have to face who's that? Hope Mannequin, Saz Mannequin, and some other fodder that we've already faced before. Now, hopefully Edgar is worth the trouble that I've been going through in this chapter. This is taking a very long time to do. Oh, and in case you didn't notice, hey, look who's that! Look who's that on our team! Is that a little? Is that little Sarah? Yes, it is. In the downtime that I had between the last video and this one, I got her maxed out. Well, level wise, anyways, all of her gear was already maxed out. Right after the pool video, so. I had done that before I even did the chapter because I knew that I would have to do the recordings for it beforehand, so I figured I'd level all that up first so that way I had it out of the way so it wouldn't distract me when I was doing this chapter. So the only thing I would have to do here is just or the only thing I would have had to do then was level up Sarah, which I already did to show you guys and give you guys a little demonstration of what she can actually do. She's a powerhouse, guys. She's definitely very strong. Like, I am very pleased with the amount of the output of damage that she can actually do. Not really damage, but what she does for the team. Like, I'm very pleased with the result. Like, I'm glad that I actually pulled for her. Like, her ability is kind of weird, but it just works really well. Cause depending on how high Tidus or Lightning are, their bravery will just skyrocket. Like, if they're even remotely close to halfway, it'll just cap them instantly. it may not seem like a lot from here, but it's because their bravery was still semi-low. If their bravery were higher, I feel like she really shines, especially during a summon. Like, during summons, the bravery gain is ridiculous. Like, you will climb bravery so fast with her, with her moonshot. I think that's what it's called, the moonshot. I just used her. I wasn't even looking at the name. Oh, what's this? Make her okay. Oh, okay. Are we gonna get Edgar now? Of course not. I guess we have to go through some battles before we can do that. I'll do this guy first. Actually, which one has less battles? This one has less battles. Hopefully, it doesn't lead me to a dead end. Which, I mean, I don't think it will because it looks like they go down the same path, but usually these solid blue guys don't, Moonlight, I'm sorry, it was not Moonshot. Moonlight. So yeah, that's and the buff that it puts up, look how much max bravery it actually gives to the team. Like, Tidus is at 5587. It takes him up to 67. Like, it's almost 1200 increased bravery. It's crazy. The amount of gain that she gives to the team. I'd say it's more than eight. Yeah, it's way more than Echoes, actually. Look at what am I talking about? Cause I know with Lightning, I think my base with Lightning is 7,000 with her self buff, which is the max bravery one, this thing, max bravery up. It's 7,000, but with Echo, it's only 7,500. So I'd say that Sarah's overall buff to the team is, pretty high. Let's go ahead and wound this guy. And then I'm just going to Flourish the Steel on Laguna, take him out. And then Tidus should be able to knock this guy out, maybe. Yeah, okay, nice. Alright, and we're moving on. Hopefully we get to the end here shortly. It seems like we're coming to the end of this thing fairly quickly. I'm hoping we do, because I actually really want to get Edgar on my team already. I've been using Sarah for a bit, on the outside. Outside of doing these recordings for this chapter, but I've been using her for Oren's co-op missions, and she seems to be really, really strong there. So we have Vaughn's Mannequin here. The boss is probably gonna be No, I can't be the Vanguard. This guy's probably gonna be in the middle. But what is this? An Iguion? 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 Okay, so it sounds like this sounds like the enemy from Final Fantasy X, actually, but it's probably a different variation. So he's actually weak to water, earth, and light, and it seems like he has a lot of stuff here. So he uses rake, bravery attack, armor cleave, melee bravery attack, and inflicts defense down. Okay, magma breath, which is probably just a AoE fire. Volcanic breath, volcanic eruption, powerful group fire magic attack. Ooh, dive bomb, melee HP attack, inflicts attack down. Fire shard, melee bravery attack plus HP attack, inflicts attack down and max bravery down. Yo, what is going on? This guy on steroids? Resonate grants party bravery based on party's initial bravery. High resonance grants party bravery based on party's initial bravery. What in the world? What? Unite recovers own HP, grants attack of defensive max bravery up and bravery regens itself, raises speed. Reunite grants attack of defensive max bravery. Yo, what in the all right, well, actually, you know, that enemy might be the one that was inside of whose trial was it? Was it Leviathan's? I want to say it was Leviathan's trial that we saw these the twin lizards. It might be who I'm thinking of. I mean, we'll see when we get to it, but I think that's who it was. I think we have seen these enemies before, but it was like a really long time ago. So I'm just gonna go ahead and use Moonlight here, get our buffs up. With Lightning, I'm gonna Flourish a Steel on Vaughn, take him out, and then with Tidus, just gonna HP attack. All right. Yeah, see, this guy was in the middle. Wow, that's interesting. Usually don't see the Vanguard armors next to the Magitek armors. It's interesting. They really pulled out all the stops with this one, guys. I'm liking this chapter. This chapter's actually been a pleasant surprise from what we've been getting lately. When it comes to the chapters, it's been very, very good. So I'm gonna go ahead and actually just use wound on this thing. And then with lightning, I'll just I'd rather just knock this thing out as fast as possible. Quick hit here. And with Sarah, I'm just going to HP attack. Tita should be able to knock him out. Yes, he can. And then I'll just use a Flourish of Steel here. And he's down for the count. Alright, wave 3. Nothing too out of the ordinary, nothing we haven't seen. I'm just going to go ahead and just bravery attack this. Slash combo this guy. And then I'm going to refresh this with Sarah before the final wave. Let's see what Yeah, I think it is them, but just a different what is this thing? It looks like it's weird. It's like the front of a lizard and the back of a lion. What is going on? This isn't a chimera, guys. Like, what is this thing? Alright, so I just refreshed buffs last turn, so I'm going to just debuff this guy with lightning. I think I'll just spark strike, because this guy's thinking about doing something, and I'm not too optimistic about finding out what it actually is gonna be. Let's see. So he's using rake. Not too much damage. Magma breath. Yeah, that's not too much damage either. Alright, so let's knock out A since he's gonna use AoE here. Which is HP attack. And then I'll just Moonlight just to refresh buffs and to raise everybody's bravery a little bit. Yeah, Unite. You're at full health. You're not getting anything back. Alright. I'm just gonna use Moonlight again. Slash combo. We're just gonna burn this guy down. Burn him to the ground. And he's down. It'll be interesting to fight those guys on hard mode. That'll be fun. That'll definitely be fun. Because there's a lot of mechanics that we saw from that, from just reading what they actually do. That they obviously, because it's the easy mode right now, because I'm just going through the story. They don't get to use a lot of that stuff, but on the hard mode, I can tell like it's probably gonna get very difficult, you know, when we get to these last bosses. All right, so we got more story. Those who would not be dominated. All right, so we meet Emperor again. To appear before me, I take it you have made up your minds. There are none among us who would follow you. We have known that from the start. Oh, then let me ask you this. Where is the purpose in repeatedly fighting meaningless battles as compelled by a pitiless god? You call all we have done so far meaningless. Claims to protect your homeworlds are, etc., etc. Worms drivel in the end. Shall I provide you with the evidence? And you're claiming you can give meaning to our battles? Precisely. Under my reign, you could personally witness your worlds being devoured. That's more like it. What? When all is said and done, we have a duty to protect our worlds from tyrants like you. Exactly. Torsions aside, we cannot allow the evil before us to go unaddressed. Even in this world, I've gathered allies, friends who won't bow to your rule. Your schemes end here. Fools, regret your decision as you fall. Oh boy. Ooh, things are getting spicy, guys. So I'm guessing we gotta fight Emperor. Oh, this will be a new enemy that we have definitely not faced before. Ooh, what does he do? Okay. Alright. So he does bravery attack, HP attack, obviously. But then he uses Dreary Cell. Increases bravery based on initial bravery. Sets Dreary Cell on target. Grants physical damage resist to self. Okay. Starfall. Ooh. Increases bravery based on initial bravery. Sets Starfall on target. Grants magic damage resist to self. Whoa. Okay, so he's like an offensive, defensive guy. He uses offense and covers himself at the same time. That's crazy. Beckoning Blast. Increases bravery based on initial bravery. Sets Beckoning Blast on target. Okay. His whole kit seems to be based on initial bravery. Mine. Increases bravery based on initial bravery. Sets Mine on target and grants speed up to self. And then his final ability is Scourge. A magic bravery attack with a fair chance of inflicting poison. Okay, so he seems to be very, very defensive while being offensive at the same time. And then we have a bunch of mannequins here that are... We have the Sarah mannequin, actually. And she uses the same abilities as our counterpart here, so... Let's go ahead... Oh, oops. Let's go ahead and jump into this one, then. And see just what... this Emperor guy can do. I don't think he will be too much of a problem in this... on the easy mode, but he probably will definitely pose a threat in the hard mode. I'm pretty positive about that. He's probably gonna cause me a few problems. All right, so we're just gonna keep burning through these guys because I'm pretty sure we can just keep one-shotting them. There's no point in just wasting time on them. I don't think the Emperor is gonna be that tanky anyways. I mean, if he gets his buffs up, he probably will be, but if not, then I think we're fine. Sorry, Sarah. I gotta do it to you. And then let's refresh our Moonlight buff before we head into this last battle. Did I wonder if we'll ever get Emperor as a character? Those who do not accept my rule are all worms. Be gone! Slash combo on this guy. Yeah, this guy seems pretty dainty. Alright, so I'm gonna use Wound here. Spark Strike. And then Quick Hit. to refresh or to get some buffs up. And then with Sarah, okay, so this is the physical one. Oh, what? Dude, that's sick! Oh, okay, so basically, if you attack him, it's like it automatically just triggers on you. That's sick. Is it continuous? Does it stay on you? Is it just, oh no, okay, I guess it's only after one use. Alright, so I'm just going to, I'm going to wound this guy again. And then I'm going to just Flourish or Steel. He'll probably die here. Nope. Okay, I guess not. Jury Cell sets. Okay, so I'm going to Flourish or Steel again. And he'll be dead. Yes. Okay, so I can admit, I dig his kit. His kit is definitely cool. Like, I didn't get to see his powerful ability, which, will, I mean, we'll probably see that in the hard mode when I get to that, you know, when we get around to doing that. But, his normal kit just seems really cool, like the whole detonation thing where it's like a landmine. Atlas Manifest. Okay. I defeated. Unbelievable. Is I suppose what you would like me to say? What? Is I suppose what you would like me to say? What the heck does that even mean? I honestly don't know what that means. I read it like 3 times and I still couldn't figure out what he was trying to say. Everyone, keep at it! Don't let your guard down! I have had enough of you for now. Oh, what is going on? What's happening? Is this Torsion? What the? What the? Yo, what is that? Yo, what the heck? I don't know about you, but I don't think I could stand serving under a coward like him. I think I agree with you, my dear. Crass displays of might bore me to tears. For now, I'm on this side, and that makes you the enemy. Everyone, thank you. Scramble as you try to flee, worms. Let's go! Yo, what is this thing? Are we seriously gonna fight this? Oh man, okay, hold on. What is this thing? Like, what actually is this thing? Okay, so we have some normal stuff. Vincent, Furion, Mannequin. We got the Dark Worm. The Abyss Worm, that thing. And then, what in the heck is this Atlas? So he's weak to fire and ice. I'm probably gonna switch out somebody for Popolimo. He is... Okay, resistance low, force slash ranged resist down. Okay, high. He's high resistance to paralysis slash max bravery down. Immune to poison, and he does. These are his abilities. He uses, if I could maneuver this, he uses punch, a melee attack, a melee bravery attack, sonic punch, a melee bravery attack with a high turn rate, roar, a group magic attack grants max bravery up, attack up, and speed up to self. HP attack, a melee HP attack, obviously. Squish, group melee bravery attack, removes all debuffs from self and buffs from target, excluding enframed effects. And then he has chain strike, group melee bravery attack plus group HP attack. Oh boy, this guy sounds like he is a treat. A real treat. So I'm going to just do this, and hopefully we can destroy this guy quickly. So let's do this. I don't know exactly how strong this guy's actually gonna be, but he seems like he's gonna be a problem. And if he is a problem on normal mode, then that means he's definitely gonna be a problem on the hard mode. But I don't really know if he's gonna actually be a problem on the normal mode yet, so we have to find that out. Alright. Finish this, let's move on. Alright, so Papa Limo, we'll just use Astro Fire here. Finish that guy off. I'll just HP attack. I think Sarah should be able to finish it. Yeah, she should be able to finish this here. And then I just gotta refresh the buff on the next turn. Yeah. Alright, so I'm going to slash combo on Vincent because I don't want his debuffs up. Oh, he died anyways. Maybe I won't have to. Okay. I they just died, okay. I'll quick hit here. I'll use Umber Ice. Moonlight. And then HP attack. Drain Head, is he gonna... Yes, he is. Alright, I'm just gonna wound. That's no bueno. Alright, let's use another Umber Ice. Slash combo, and he should... No. I think he had... No. Oh yeah, it's because Tidus is missing HP. Okay, and now we're moving on to this abomination. Oh my lord, he's huge! Take care of them from me, giant from another world. Okay, let's just get a slash combo up. I'm assuming this guy has massive HP. Or not. Alright, Umber Ice. We'll just do, a wound, and then quick hit. He's probably gonna break, Papa, and he's gonna debuff us, or I mean, not debuff, but take our buffs. I'm gonna Moonlight. I'll, slash combo this to reapply my debuffs since he took them off, and then with Papa again, we'll just Umber Ice, because this guy is super vulnerable to this. We'll debuff him again. And then we'll quick hit. Sonic Punch, he's gonna have high turn rate here. Alright, I mean, it was okay. It wasn't that much turn rate. But, Moonlight, we should be fine. Tidus should be able to finish, yep. Okay, so, he wasn't as bad as I thought, but I can assure you he's gonna be a major threat on the hard mode. I have a feeling he's gonna, like, kick my butt when I... For lack of a better word, he's gonna kick my butt when I get around to this hard mode. So, are we gonna get Edgar after this? Or like, I mean, I've been waiting for Edgar this whole time, unless I missed him somewhere along the line. I hope not. The Road to Answers. We closed the torsion. I guess it belonged to that big guy, Koopo. Huh. So this is what y'all were talking about. Oh, everyone all right? Give me a moment to bring her down. Edgar, I have heard a lot about you. The king leading an independent team of warriors. And you, one of the first chosen warriors with the light, so to speak. Glad to finally meet you. Tell me, if you knew of our campaign, why did you not join us? Like me, he has little faith in those gods. Lightning, you look lovely today. It's as though rose petals came fluttering in. I've had little faith in him with that attitude too. Color me shocked! I jest. Let me tell you about the returners, while that Moogle isn't around. I believe you've heard their names, but this world was created by two gods. The goddess Materia, and the god Spiritus. Yes. Apparently, these two are at odds with each other. Why was the world made? Why are the dimensions distorted? We have no answers to these basic issues. That's why I thought it necessary to have a group attached to neither of the gods. Attached to neither. You were searching for the reason for these battles. You sent several warriors to our side. That was also part of your investigation. That was a little bit of my direction. A little bit of their own cognizance. Free will is what makes us human, after all. So what made the King of Info cast his own crown into the ring of all, of a sudden? According to Lael, you've got a date with Divinity. That's a party I'd like to crash. There's a thing or two I want to confirm. Very well. I see no reason to deny your request, although I do not know how Mog will react. He's already acknowledged Edgar has the light. I doubt he'd go back on that. There you have it. I look forward to working with you. Let us... the sticker. Let us together uncover the truth of this world. Is this the end of chapter 9? Dun, dun, dun. I think it is. Alright, we finally got Edgar. Torsion is closed and the field is cleared. Alright. Well, alright, that takes care of chapter 9, guys. Alright, that's gonna do it for this video. And finally, we got through my chapter 9 playthrough. I know this took forever to finish, but I had a lot of other things I had to work on before I could finally get around to editing and fixing this whole thing up. I'm going to be working on this format, and this is definitely the way I'm going to be handling the chapters in the future, because I like the way that it worked out. I like that I was able to section it piece by piece and just, you know, give that as a like kind of like a real story to the game. But I'm going to work on improving this method that I have, and hopefully it turns out better later on, you know, when I fix it up and, you know, make improvements to it. But I hope you all enjoy joining me through chapter 9, and next up will be my hard mode bosses walkthrough for this chapter, so be on the lookout for that. And yeah, until next time, bye guys.